Hello students, welcome back to mathematics class. In today's class, let us solve some more problems of exercise number 2.5 based on Pythagoras theorem. Let us start it now. Okay. In an equilateral triangle ABC, D is a point on side BC such that BD is 1/3 BC. Prove that 9AD square is equal to 7AB square. Okay, so what you have to see here first, in an equilateral triangle ABC, which type of triangle I have to draw? I have to draw the triangle equilateral. Is it doing well? Can I draw the triangle equilateral? So, equilateral triangle. What is the property of equilateral triangle, children? Equilateral triangle means all sides are equal. All sides are equal. In the sense, AB is equal to BC is equal to AC. All sides are equal. Right, children? So, can I take it as X? This is X means what is this? X. All sides are equal. Okay, so this is also X. Now see here, all sides are equal. Then what are the properties equilateral triangle have? See here, one more thing. What is that? Whenever you draw one perpendicular, it bisects the base. It bisects the base, right? So see here, in an equilateral triangle ABC, D is a point on side BC. Where is BC? Here, right? D is a point on BC. You have to draw it, students. Can I draw D on the point? Point on BC. So I will draw D here. Okay, so D is a point on side BC. Draw. There are numbers such that BD is equal to 1/3 BC. BD, this length is equal to. So BD is 1/3 BC. 1/3 of BC. Okay, then BD length is 1/3 BC is given. Then what you have to prove? Prove that 9AD square is equal to 7AB square. 9AD square is equal to 7AB square. Where is AD square? Okay, so we have to join this side. Is equal to this side square. Like this, you have to do this. But children, so whatever you do here, is there any right angle triangle, children? Is there any perpendicular means given? Not, no. Then it is very difficult to solve this problem. So what you have to do is, you have to draw one perpendicular to BC. Okay, so there is a, this line is not a perpendicular. I didn't say it's a perpendicular. Okay, so just joint here, but that line is not a perpendicular. Without perpendicular, you cannot use Pythagoras theorem. So can I draw one perpendicular there? Okay, see here, from the vertex, if I draw here, okay, so this is the perpendicular. Perpendicular means how much degree? 90 degree. Is it okay? So when I draw here, I will give the name as EA. Is it okay? So now see here, I draw AD perpendicular to BC. AD perpendicular to BC. So this is one extra topic you have to do. Otherwise, we cannot solve this using Pythagoras. Is it okay, children? So now what is given? What is to do? Let us see now. See, first, what is given? ABC is an equilateral triangle. So, what you write first? Triangle ABC is an equilateral. Is an equilateral triangle. Okay, then what is equilateral triangle? All sides are equal. We can write like this. AB is equal to BC is equal to AC, all sides are equal. So all sides are equal means I wrote as X. It's very easy to understand. All sides are equal. AB, BC, CD. Instead of writing that, AB is X, BC is X, AC is also X. Is it okay? Can I write here X? So yes. Is it okay? Now what happens here? One more thing is given. What is that? BD is given. BD is how much? BD is 1/3 of BC. BD is 1/3 of BC. Okay, 1/3 of BC you know. Then what else? Here you draw one perpendicular, right? So let us draw AE perpendicular to BC. Otherwise you cannot do the problem there. So let us draw AD perpendicular to BC. AD perpendicular to BC. What is the work of perpendicular, children? So in an equilateral triangle, perpendicular bisects the base, right, children? So in an equilateral triangle, we know that. In an equilateral triangle, altitude bisects the base. Altitude bisects the base. That means what happens? What happens? BE is equal to EC. This length bisects the base means BE is equal to EC. Can I write like that again? So because of this sentence, you can write here BE is equal to EC. Is equal to how much? Can anyone say? BE is equal to EC means what is that? So BE is half of BC. That also we can write. So BE length is, only is 10 means this is half of that. Okay, no children? So half of BE, we can write like this. BE is also half of BC. Bisect means mean that only, children. So BE length. So here to here length. Don't take a different decision. BE is equal to EC means BE is half of BC. Otherwise, EC is half of BC. Which can I write like that? Yes. So I will write here. See. So BE is half of BC. Okay. So you know because of this, what is that? An equilateral triangle by its altitude bisects the base. That's why we can write half of that full length. Is it okay? So if I write this, this can also be written like this. BC is nothing but how much is then? X, right? So can I write here X by 2? Half into X means what, children? Half into X. So half into X means X by 2, right? X by 2 is X by 2. So the length of BE length is how much becoming? Full length is X. Okay, full length is X. So this length is X by 2. Here to here. So this is also X by 2. Right? So the full length you know X. Bisect means it is becoming its half. So very important problem, children. Yes, no, let me write, but it's very easy to understand. Is it okay? So now BE is equal to AC is equal to half BC or half into X by BC is already I wrote X there. So X by X, X by 2. So the length of BE you got and BC also you got. Okay, sir. Now what you have to do? So I got length of AB. I know already X. I know the length of BE. Okay, so AE length can I find out? Why? Because it's a right angle triangle, children. So if I take AE, it's a right angle triangle. So we can use Pythagoras theorem. Right now, children, don't see here. See the triangle properly. But inside another triangle is there. Which triangle you want, you take it. be a right angle triangle. So now see, in triangle ABE, so this way you can find. Okay, so before that, you know the full length BE. Do you know the length of DE? Do you know the length of DE? How can I find the length of DE? Can I find? Because that too, those two are important. Okay, so can I find that? See, DE. DE is equal to small length. DE is equal to BE minus BD. Can I write like that? Full length minus half length. See here. DE is how much? BE minus BD. Can I write like that? Then? So DE is how much? BE minus BE minus BD. This and all we will find out and keep it. Later just the application. This is okay, it will feel very easy. So now see, BE length I want means I know the length of BE. I have written already here. BD length I already know. Yes, Mr. Right? So I can also be written like this. 1/3 of S. BC length is S. So S by 3. So what is the length of BD? BD you know already they have given. X by 3. So this small length is X by 3. This length is X by 2. The remaining length we can find out very easily. Yes, Kuchira? If it is 10 cm, this is 3 means remaining centimeter can find out or not. 10 minus 3. Right, seven. You can write like that. So same method here also. So full length is B minus BD. Okay, concentrate on that figure. So then, what is BE? BE is how much? X by 2 minus BD how much? X by 3. Okay, so now before I get the denominator, what you have to do? You have to take the LCM. What is the LCM of these two? 3 is the 6, right? 6 is the LCM. Now, 6 is the LCM means 2. How much the 6? 2, 3 is the. So here 3 is R means half also 3. 3 how much does 6? 3, 2 is R. Here also 2 is R. 3 into X, 3X minus 2 into X, 2X. What is the remaining answer? 3X minus 2X is 1X by 6. So every length I got now. See here, I got another length. Who is that? DE is X by 6. X by 6. After getting all the length, I can get the answer of this. Is it okay, children? So, this one, all the ingredients are ready before starting our dishes. Yes, no? So, like that, you have to keep ready everything. Now, we will go to proof. Okay? See? Okay. So, now, which triangle can I take here? Which triangle can I take here? I want AB square, right? AB square 1, AD square 1. AB coming which triangle is that? Let us take now. Okay. So AB square coming triangle is this. ABE. E is how much degree? 90 degree. So in triangle AB. AB square is equal to AE square plus BE square. Okay, so now AB square I already know. AB is I know how much? Yes. BE I know X by 2. Yes, teacher. AB can find out through this. The altitude I can find out through this. Altitude I can find out through this. Is it okay? So two sides you know, third side is very easy you can find out by Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so now use Pythagoras. Pythagoras. So here AB come on x, x square. AB square is x square. AE I don't know. Let us find it. Okay, plus BE square. BE is how much? See, already written here. BE is x by 2. X by 2 whole square. Okay, now simplify this. X square write as it is. AE square write as it is. Plus x into x. X square by 2 to 4. Now both x and x terms bring into same sign. So that we will get the value of AE square. So, x square minus x square by 4 is equal to AE square. Arrange for AE square. Arrange for AE square. See, x square plus x square by 4 coming here minus x square by 4. So, take the LCM here. 4 into x square. 4x square minus x square by 4 is equal to AE square. Okay, so now 4x square minus 1x square, 4 minus 1, 3, right? 3x square. 3x square by 4 is equal to AE square. Yes, you may be thinking, why teacher got AE square? Is there any AE square in this? It is needed, children. Later to find out. Is it okay? So let it be as it is. Now, another triangle we can take so that I have to get this. Triangle ABE, smaller triangle I have to take in this. This is also a right angle triangle. Since the perpendicular is for big triangle also, small triangle also, same, no children. So we can take the triangle ABE. In triangle ABE, angle ABE is, E angle E is 90 degree. Okay, 90 degree. Why Pythagoras, what is AC? AD square. 90 degree front is this side, right? This side. Hypotenuse square is equal to sum of other two squares. So hypotenuse square is equal to sum of other two squares. You put it. Okay, so now what can we do here? See, AD square is equal to AD square plus DE square. So that shaded portion triangle only have to take. Is it okay? So AD square is equal to AD square plus DE square by Pythagoras. Now AD square anyhow, I don't know, right? I want AD square here. Let it be AD square. Okay. AD just now I got it. That I applied here. 3A square by 4 plus DE square. Sorry, DE square. DE is how much? X by 6. Already it is written there. Yes, minute. X by 6. Whole square. Now what you have to do? Take the LCM. Double do, then add it. Okay. So 3x square by 4 as it is. 3x square by 4 as it is. Plus x into x. X square. X into x. X square by 6 is 36. What is the common denominator? 36, right? So 36 is the common denominator. 36 is the common denominator. 4, how much sum? 36, 4, 9 is the. Here 9 is the, means also 9. 36, 1 is the. Here also 1 is the. So 9, 3 is the. 27 x square plus x square 1 is the x square. So now here the next step, AD square is equal to 27 plus 1 x square. Then 27 x square plus 1 x square, that is 28 x square by 36. Okay? Okay, now see here, 28 and 36 comes in which table, children? 28. Which table? 4 sevens are, right? 4 sevens are 28. 4 nines are 36. 4 nines are. Now remaining is 7x square by 9 is equal to ad square. So the given thing we got now, see children, ad square 9 more, oh children, here see, remaining is what? 9 into ad square, 9 ad square is equal to 7 into x square, 7 into x square, 7 into x square. I don't want x square, I want ab square, right? So x means two children, x means either that ab or bc or ac, which can I write now? Which one I want? Yes, that only I can say. So x can be taken as ab. Ab, can I take ab as x? X as ab? Yes. So now 9 ad square is equal to 7 ab square. 7 ab square. That's all about this problem. See, 9 ab square is equal to 7 ab square. So these all together, you have to do all the lengths right properly. Is it okay? First, what we have written? ABC is an equilateral triangle. Equilateral means all sides are equal. First, draw the triangle. Then, write all sides are equal. So, all sides are taken as x children. Okay. So, equilateral triangle means all sides are equal. All sides is taken as x. Okay. So, then x I have taken. BD length already they have given them. This is all given them. Right here. 1 by 3rd. BC is BC means what? X. X1 by x. X by 3. Right? So, BD length I got. BD length is this much. X by 3 I got. Right, children? So, there afterwards, there is no perpendicular means we cannot use Pythagoras. Figure is not given. Figure we have drawn. But the perpendicular is not given. So let us draw the perpendicular. Perpendicular is AE perpendicular to BC. Where there is 90 degree, we can use Pythagoras theorem. Okay, one more thing you learned in equilateral triangle, that when an arc is drawn to the base, that bisects the base. Equilateral triangle, arc is bisects the base. That is the thing that having the meaning. What is the meaning? BE becoming. Like this, BE becoming, EC becoming. That becomes half or not children. So it is half of BC. Half of BC. BE and EC is equal to half of BC. Half of BC is how much? BC can be taken as X. X by 2. Another length I got. Then the third length I will find out. DE. DE I want. Very small length here. See, this length I want. This length I will find out means full length minus BD length you have to do. So BE minus BD, it means DE getting DE. DE length gets by DE minus BD. Okay, concentrate on the figure and do it like that only. Practice nature. Without practice, this cannot be. Finally, you cannot do any of the things. Is it okay? So practice it regularly. So now see here, x by 2 minus x by 2, we're taking s here, what you got? X by 6. So that is the length of DE. DE is x by 6. Now every length I got, AB length I know, BE length I know, AE length I can find out using Pythagoras theorem. So what is that? In triangle ABE, ABE also 90 degree triangle, ABE also right angle triangle. Yes, no? So first which one are you taking? Let us take it first. Okay? ABE. AB square is equal to AE square plus BE square. So AB means X square. AE anyhow I didn't get. I have to get. Okay? So BE means X by 2. BE means X by 2. Everything kept ready there. So X by 2. Now double it. You will get like this. Bring it to same side. Take the LCM. Okay? These are the basic things you have to do it yourself. Okay, then AE you are getting, AE square you are getting, AE square 3x by 4. Retain AE square as it is. Don't make square, put square becomes nothing. Okay, because later I get one more triangle here, ADE. In that, E is 90 degree. AD square is equal to AE square plus AE square. By calculating, you are getting 7 by 9x square. Okay, children. So 9 is this side. 9 square is equal to 7 into x square. X can be written any one of these three. Okay, so AB can be written, BC can be written, AC can be written. Which one I want to do here along with the 7? AB square. So I have to put 7 x square plus 7 AB square. Okay, so 9 AB square is equal to 7 AB square. Hence, 2 rules get right. Hence, 2. Understand and do. Okay, practice it daily. Otherwise, it is very difficult to understand. Okay, now let us move to next problem. Okay, so next problem is same equilateral triangle based on equilateral triangle itself. Okay.
Altitude there. Is it okay? So one of its altitude. That means
AD square means I have to prove. Is it okay? So everything you have understand the question and you have to write like this. Is it okay? So now what is it? See, 3 times. 3 times means 3 into square of one of its sides, either AB or BC or AC. Any one of the sides square is equal to 4 times square of its altitude. Okay, so like this you have to prove. So this much you know. So already you know that. Already you know that in equilateral triangle, in an equilateral triangle, altitude bisects the base. Altitude bisects the base. Okay, so what is the meaning of this here? BD is half of BC. BD is equal to DC. Along with that, BD is equal to DC is also equal to, we can also written like this. BD is half of BC. Okay, so BD is half of BC. Okay, so BC can be written as x multiplied. So x by 2. Okay, so x into 1, x by the x by 2. So this is the length is x by 2 here. So this is also x by 2. Full length is x. Right? So now this side you know, this side you know. Can we find out AD square? Right, because I want to find AD square, right children? So this is a right angle triangle. Right angle triangle. So you can use Pythagoras theorem for that. So which triangle can I take? So in triangle ABD. In triangle ABD, angle ADB is equal to 90 degree. So by Pythagoras, what is that Pythagoras? 90 degree front to side is a hypotenuse square is equal to sum of other two squares. So AB square is equal to, you can write AB square is equal to AD square plus BD square. Okay, student. So AB, how much you know? AB already you know. X, can I write there? AB plus X. X square. X square, AD square. AD, I don't know. AD square. Plus BD, I already know. X by 2. X by 2 whole square. Now simplify it. Okay? So right here, x square, a square into, sorry, plus x into x square by 2 2s are 4. Now what can I do? X and x bring it to same side. So x square plus comes here minus x square by 4 is equal to ad square. So it nearly came. Now another thing, take the LCM. 4 into x square minus x square. Okay, x square by 4 is equal to ad square. 4 x square minus x square, 3 x square. Right? So 3 x square by 4 is equal to ad square. Now where is 4 will go? 4 will go that side, right? So this is cross. Remaining thing what here? Remaining is 3x square is equal to 4 into AD square. 4 AD square. Okay, so I got the same thing, right? So 3 and 3. But x square I got. X square place, what can I write? X place, AB there means x square place, AB square. Can I write? Okay, so here 3 into AB square is equal to 4 AD square. Okay, 3 times the square of one of the sides is equal to 4 times the square of one of its altitude. Same thing we got. Yes, the children? Yes. Hence, proof. Okay, that's all about this problem. The next class, let us move to some more problems of Pythagoras theorem. Till then, take care. Thank you.